have to ask her later. I like you guys, you're smart, you read and stuff. I knew specifically wasn't a word. My boyfriend is also Latino, my boyfriend is Mexican. I love Mexican dudes, I love Mexican men. I knew I was gonna end up with a Mexican guy because I love tacos. I'm a food person. I was like, the closer I get to Mexican food, the better I am in life. And I remember when I met my boyfriend, I thought he was like the tallest Mexican dude I remember, like, because he's 6'1", that's huge. Like, I don't know about here, but in New York, our Mexicans come travel size. So when I met him, I was like, what are you made up of, several smaller Mexicans? Is that how this works? Like one of those Russian dolls, like Jorge, Jesus. You guys are all adorable. We've been together a few years now, me and him, and we're trying to have a baby. Thank you, I'm going to tell him real soon. I'm kidding, I'm not going to tell him. That would ruin a surprise. No, I'm not that crazy chick that does that, though. There's chicks out there that do that, though. There are crazy chicks out there. Well, I live with my guy friends. I have a lot of guy friends, they always say the same thing to me. They're always like, I just want to find a chick that's not crazy. I'm always like, that's adorable. Let me know when you find that in a unicorn. Where are you, Narnia? I don't know where that happens. Ladies, we're all crazy, right? Just own it. Just own your crazy. Own it. That's right, own your crazy. I told my boyfriend when we first met, I was like, I will cut you. I don't need a reason. Maybe one day I just freak out and you're in the room. That's how people get cut. It's okay to own your crazy, because I like when I say that, I see the reaction from the women. And the women are like, yeah, we crazy. And then I'll see a few women that are like, not me, she's not talking about me. I don't know, I'm not like that at all, I'm perfectly normal. Sure, she'd probably kill somebody. I'm telling you right now, guys, I feel so bad for you because you're always trying to figure us out. You're always trying to figure a woman out, it's not gonna happen. We think on completely different levels, you guys understand that? I love the way men think. I wish I could think like a man. That would be logical in every situation. You have a problem, you find a solution, that's the end of your problem. That's beautiful. That sounds like a fairy tale to me. Because like most women, I am an emotional thinker. Everything involves my feelings. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? You do. So I don't think like that. Everything involves my feelings. I have a problem, I find a solution, but I don't know how I feel about the solution, so now I have two problems. This just got really crazy. You understand that kind of mentality that you guys are trying to decipher? That's the first thing you have to accept, that we think completely differently. The second thing is that you have to know that us women, our brains, 24 hours. Right? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Every woman in here knows what I'm talking about. And every man in here is like, that's physically impossible. You gotta sleep at some point. No, we don't. No, we don't. We're perfectly fine watching you guys sleep. And every girl has done it. Every woman in here has watched her boyfriend sleep at some point. And it is just as creepy as it sounds. We don't care. You have to understand, it is miraculous to us when you fall asleep, gentlemen. Why? Because it happens in 2 seconds. You guys go, I'm tired. What? You just hit with a tranquilizer dart. What just happened? How is it possible? But you know what it is? It is amazing to us that it happens that fast, because it don't happen for us like that. Right, ladies? It doesn't happen like that. The second we get tired, here's what happens. The second we get tired, the second our eyes start to close, it's like our brains come in and go, there's just this one thing. You can just wake up for a second. I really want to talk to you, and then I'm totally going to let you sleep. Right? And it's never one thing. It's a series of pointless thoughts. Starts off with one thing real simple. You'd be like, well, maybe I'll wear that blue outfit tomorrow, but not the blue one, because it kind of makes me look fat, but not too fat. Because last time I wore it, Karen said I looked nice, and she's never nice to me. I don't even consider her a real friend, because I don't really trust her. But I've had girlfriends before that I don't really trust, and I feel like one of those women that doesn't have a lot of good girlfriends, because I don't trust a lot of women. But then I don't want to be the girl that has a lot of guy friends, because that looks kind of dirty, and I don't want to be that chick. But then I wonder if I do have a lot of guy friends. Sometimes I think to myself, are they really my friends? Are they trying to get with me? Because that worries me. Like, what kind of girl do they think I am? And you just keep going and going. afford them. Like, our bodies are literally like, we gotta shut her down now. This is never gonna end. That's why I feel bad for guys always trying to figure out their woman. You ever see, and I know this has happened to men before, I know this happened to you guys. Your girlfriend's upset, right? And you come in and you want to fix the problem. You come in and you're like, what's wrong, babe? What's wrong? Don't ask us, we don't know. We don't know yet. There are a million thoughts going through my head. I haven't picked the one that is bothering me today. Give me some more time. And I feel bad because you guys will try, because men are problem solvers by nature. That's what you're taught as kids, to solve problems. What are you given to play with as kids? Legos, tools. You get to fix stuff, make stuff. We get Barbie. She don't even have a job. But she has a house and a car, you know what I'm saying? Barbie worked her way to that car. So I'll tell you right now, guys, don't try to guess what's wrong with your woman. Because I feel like men walk into a situation, they feel like it's a multiple choice. Like you could throw out suggestions. That is a danger zone. Don't come into a room where your girlfriend is upset and be like, isn't that thing I said about your mother? Now it is, congratulations. I was just having a fat day, but now I'm having a fat day and you're an idiot. Congratulations. Right now, I'm gonna give you a piece of advice. If your woman is upset and you notice, just hide. Just run somewhere, hide under something. Get safe before it's too late. Save yourself. And that has been my time. I have been Gina Brion.